Arrive on your mat, letting go, preparing to be mindful, to be calm, to find comfort in your practice today. Sometimes it's nice to just find a wall for support, whatever that space may be in your area. And just place your back, sit your back against a wall or a closet, finding a shape that's comfortable for your body, a sukhasana. Crossing your legs, sitting on a padded blanket, a bolster, or extending your legs long in front of you. Settling into the moment, letting go of any responsibility that you might have just for a short time. Letting your hands rest on your lap, feeling a groundedness, or perhaps turning your palms up, allowing your body to receive. Find a shape that feels comfortable for you today. Letting yourself be easy, reminding yourself to always be gentle to your body. Noticing how the body feels, still letting the crown reach skyward, keeping the spine long and erect, settling into the earth, allowing the earth to receive you, feeling soft, feeling calm, inviting yourself to sit and let go in your safe space, your sacred space. Connecting to the breath, being in the moment, perhaps setting an intention for your practice of peace, of calmness. Let the universe receive your intention. Honor it as you practice. Noticing the breath. Feeling the breath gently move through your body. A gentle inhale nourishing the front body, the ribs, the back body. And then a gentle exhale, releasing, letting go, breath by breath, within the moment, mindfully, with awareness. Releasing from your sukhasana, your easy pose. Letting yourself come to the mat, legs extended long in front of you, arms reaching towards your toes, and just walk the buttocks up towards the front and towards the back of your mat, inviting a little stretch, a little movement in your body, mindfully. Letting go and coming around in a table position, wrists under shoulders, moving the spine, inhaling and exhaling and releasing, tucking tailbone and spine and chin. Feeling the movement in the vertebrae as you gently and mindfully awaken the body in a cat dog. Return to a neutral spine. Inhale your right arm, thread it under your left shoulder, release your cheek to the mat. Feel a gentle stretch in the right shoulder. You can walk your fingertips up towards the front of the mat, walking them up, feeling a deeper stretch. Or you can even take a bind, moving that left arm behind you. Try both shapes, both movements, see what feels right for you on this side. Rest in the moment, find the breath. Gently and with kindness awaken the body. release to a table position, thread the left arm underneath the right shoulder, and again, come down on your cheek. Walk the right fingertips towards the front of the mat. Walk them out, feel a deep stretch in your left shoulder, or again, invite the bind behind your back. See if the bind feels better on this side than it did on the right side. Try the shapes. Each time you come to your mat, a different shape, a different position may feel more comfortable. Know that these movements are always available for you, these modifications. Come up, return to a table position. Move your right leg through. Have some blocks for support if you need them. Want to make everything gentle and everything comfortable for your body. Extend your left leg and just move your left leg a little bit longer behind you as you come into a winged dragon. The foot is, you can't see it so much in this video, but the foot on the right leg is turned on the outer edge. You can use the blocks to receive your forearms. You're stretching the back legs, quads, and hip flexors. And you're opening your hips and your groin area in this winged dragon pose. You can let the head rest on stacked fists. You can use one of the blocks. And you can hold this pose for several minutes or less or longer. Whatever feels comfortable for your body. Find the breath, maybe release a little bit more. Find comfort, find stillness, and always be mindful of the movement. Be gentle to your body, be kind to yourself. When you're ready to release, straighten the arms, move the right leg behind you, and prepare for winged dragon on the opposite side. The left knee comes forward, the right leg extends behind you, lengthen it a little bit more. You can always place a pad under that extended leg if there's any discomfort. And you could see the way I wing the foot on the left knee. Turn to the outer edges of the foot. And again, you can have blocks available to rest your forearms. You can let your head come down on a block or on stacked fists. You walked the knee out to the side of your mat before you winged your foot. And just rest with the breath. Let go, release. Find comfort in the pose. Notice the difference from right to left. Settle in. Bring your attention to the breath. Let the breath guide you and be your teacher in this pose. And as you're ready to release, the left leg moves back to meet the right. Find a bolster or a blanket if you have. For padding, for support, as you prepare to move into a saddle pose. You can always place an extra layer of padding under your knees if you need, or under your ankles or feet. You can place a blanket on the bolster to receive your neck. Your knees are bent, you're sitting in between your feet. If you have a healthy spine, you could move the bolster away from you. If your spine is unhealthy, you're going to move it a little bit closer if there's any disc issues or back issues. Let the back body come down onto the bolster. Adjust the blanket right underneath your neck. And just settle in and breathe. Stretching your quads and your hip flexors. It's a very comfortable pose once you allow your body to move into the shape and to feel comfortable. If there's any discomfort keeping both legs bent, you can extend one leg at a time. If you feel comfortable with both legs bent, just reposition yourself so that both legs are underneath your back body. Your chest is receiving, your heart is open, your chin is slightly tucked. You're connecting to the breath. This pose, once you find the comfort of this pose and the shape, it's very nice to stay in this saddle pose for several minutes, 5 minutes or longer. Readjusting the blanket underneath your neck, finding the breath, stretching the quads and the hip flexors, and connecting with the breath. Finding a stillness. Finding the breath. When you're ready to release, very mindfully and slowly, press into the earth. Come up with an erect spine. Move the bolster out of your way, soles of your feet on the mat. Just turn your knees from right to left, a gentle windshield wiper. Just finding some movement in your knees and your legs. Extend your legs long in front of you, and if you had a bolster or a folded blanket, rest into your Paschimottasana, your forward fold. Let the bolster be vertical on your lap. Your arms come alongside your body, and you could use the blocks if necessary to receive your forearms, or they can just rest alongside the bolster on the mat. Your forehead can be received by stacked fists, or again, you can use a bolster or a folded blanket. Just rest and let the body melt into the bolster. Let the bolster receive the front body. Finding the breath, calming the mind, calming the nervous system. In your Paschimottasana, your forward fold. A gentle inhale and a gentle exhale. Softening the breath. Releasing a little bit more. Letting the spine become erect when you're ready to release, moving the bolster or blankets and blocks out of your area. Widening the legs as you prepare for a forward fold. Your feet are flexed. You can place a blanket or a towel roll underneath your knees. You can even bend your knees so that their legs are not straight and there's no tension in the hamstrings. Let your front body roll forward. Extend your spine long. Receive your forehead on a block or stacked fists or right on the mat. Keep your legs long, feel the stretch in the thighs and the hamstrings, feet are flexed. Move the torso over to the right leg, fold over the right leg, find length with the back body, feel the stretch in your quads and your hamstrings, and you could even keep the right arm on the mat, bent forearm, and move the left arm overhead, gazing up towards the sky for a moment, deepening the stretch, or just fold over the right leg, feeling a stretch and the length in the side body. Move back to a forward fold, and then allow your body to gracefully move over to the left leg. Begin by lengthening over the left leg, flexed foot, or extend the right arm overhead, the left elbow in front of the leg, and feel the stretch in the side body. Whatever feels right for you, try each move. take a few breaths, and then return to a forward fold. Maybe lengthening a little bit more, extending the back body. And then pressing into the earth, coming up to a seated position. Bending the knees. And moving into a tight child pose. Arms can be in front of you, stacked with forehead receiving, stacked fists, or behind you, touching the soles of your feet. Inhale and feel the ribs and the back body widen. And exhale, the buttocks move slowly and closer to the soles of your feet. Give yourself a well-deserved rest, a mindful rest, connecting to the breath. Press into the earth in your table position. Walk the palms up one hand length and move into your Adho Mukha Shavasana, your downward facing dog. Pedal the feet from right to left, come up on toes. Let the soles of the feet eventually, if possible for your body and your shape, move down to the earth. Broaden the shoulders, palms pressed into the earth, fingertips pointing towards the front of the mat. And then walk the toes right up towards the front of your mat. Hang for a moment in your forward fold, your Uttanasana. If there's any discomfort in the hamstrings, bend your knees. Crisscross your arms into a ragdoll position. And then eventually straighten the legs, circle the sun, come up off of the body, a gentle back bend. Hands come down in front of the heart center, prayer hands. Just find your place, notice how the body feels. Be mindful, be aware, be compassionate. As you prepare for a balance pose, the stork pose, the weight moves into the left leg, the arms come up alongside the body, and the right leg lifts. Flex the foot, gaze in front of you at your drishti point, your focal point, and then slowly release the arms alongside your body. Step the left leg back as you prepare for pyramid pose. Arms crisscross behind you. The left hip moves back a little bit as you begin to fold forward over your forward leg. The hips are squared, the crown extends, and you can use blocks to receive your forearms. You can rest your forearms on the mat, or you can move them behind your back body again. You're balancing with focus, with calmness, stretching the shoulders, stretching the hamstrings. Come up slowly. Release the arms. If you have blocks, put them on the high side. Inhale and lift your left leg behind you as you move into a warrior three pose, stretching the shoulders and the back muscles, improving your balance and posture, invigorating yourself, energizing yourself, all mindfully. Slowly lower the left leg, let it move in towards the right, and prepare for warrior three with the opposite leg lifted, your right leg lifted. You're still holding onto the blocks, your gaze is forward or down at the mat, whatever is comfortable for your neck. Improving your balance, energizing yourself. Bend your knees, release, and come up. Prepare for your balance pose on the opposite side. Inhale your arms alongside your body. All the weight moves into your right leg as you inhale and lift your left leg. Bend your knee, flexed foot. Gaze over the front of your mat. Come down and prepare for your pyramid pose. Your left leg is forward. Your arms can be crisscrossed behind your back as you fold forward. Hips square towards the front of the room, lowering the torso forward, finding the mat for balance, or finding blocks on the low side, medium side, or high side, bending your forearms. Stretching the shoulders, stretching the hamstrings. keeping the crown extended, engaging the belly and coming up slowly, mindfully, pressing into the left leg, moving the right leg to meet the left leg, inhaling the arms overhead, swan diving down, Uttanasana, your forward fold. Find a gentle half lift, gazing over the front of your mat, long spine. Step the left leg back, step the right leg back. Move into a plank pose, energy radiating through the soles of your feet, pressing into your palms, and then twisting your plank. Your right arm is pressing into the mat, your left arm is lifting skyward. You could modify this pose by releasing your right knee to the mat. Whatever feels comfortable, whatever feels right for your body. Move into a full plank again, reposition yourself and twist in the opposite direction. Your left arm presses into the mat, your right arm reaches towards the sky. Remember that you can lower the back knee if you need to modify the pose. Move the spine forward and back. Release right knee, released left knee. Come down to the earth slowly with love and compassion for yourself. Soles of your feet on the mat. Find a block as you prepare for a supported bridge pose, Setu Bandhasana. Walk the soles of your feet towards your buttocks and begin a deep relaxation, stretching the neck, stretching the hamstrings, calming the nervous system, letting the block be the support for your body. You can move the block on the low side or the medium side. I have it on the medium side. Arms released by the side of your body, settling the body, calming the mind, but being mindful of the breath, lowering the heart rate. With kindness, with love, with compassion. Hugging the knees in, massaging the lower back from right to left. Soles of your feet on the mat, and then twisting the knees towards the right as you prepare for Supta Matsyendrasana, a side twist. Your arms can be in goal posts above you or extended long across the heart center. Place a blanket in between the knees. Keep your knees stacked and feel the length in your body as you relax the spine, as you gently massage the spine. Your gaze is in the opposite direction of your knees, or your gaze can be towards the sky, depending on what feels right for your neck today. Sit in the moment. Be mindful of the moment. Be aware of the breath moving through your body. Let the prana nourish you. Allow yourself to be nurtured. Allow yourself to receive. If your chin is turned, let your gaze be towards the sky. Knees meet the chin. And again, roll from side to side, massaging the spine. As you prepare for your Supta Matsyendrasana on the opposite side, find your blanket or towel roll as you stack your knees. Your gaze is in the opposite direction. Arms are across the heart center. Palms can be towards the sky, or you can move your arms and goalposts behind you. Feel the spine lengthen and relax. Feel the gentle massage and gentle twist in the spine. Remembering to turn your gaze towards the sky if there's any neck difficulties or if your neck is complaining today. Rest in the moment. Allow your body to settle. allow yourself to connect to the breath. Returning to a gentle inhale and a gentle exhale. Remove the blanket. Chin returns to center and hug the knees in again. Let the legs come up. Find the outer edges of the feet as you move into a happy baby pose. Opening the inner thighs, stretching the spine, letting the heart rate reduce. And then preparing for your final pose, your Shavasana. If you have a sandbag, you can place the sandbag for extra weight across your abdomen. Let your back body be received by the earth. Feet gently splaying apart, arms alongside your body, chin slightly tucked. Your deep rest and relaxation. Let your attention move to different parts of the body and then slowly relax and let go. Find a deep awareness of how your body feels so you can absorb all the benefits of your practice. A passive state, releasing tension, focusing on the gentle breath. Thank you. begin to awaken from your shavasana. Deepen the breath, move the soles of your feet on the mat, release the sandbag if you used one, and roll to your side, cradling the head, stacking the knees, honoring your intention, remembering it now as a present truth. Pressing the earth away, letting the body come up. The head comes up last. And then find that comfortable place against your wall, your closet. Find your sukhasana, let the wall support you. As you return to an easy pose, hands in front of your heart center, thanking yourself for practicing today, for being mindful, for being aware of how the body feels. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. May there be peace, peace, peace. As you walk this earth, all the days of your life. Namaste.